Over the last several decades, we've been witness to the dawning of what some have called the information age. Much like learning to use fire, creating the wheel, or the innovation of mass production, how we have learned to develop and harness information has profound implications for the evolution of the human condition. The primary innovation of our age is the rapid development of artificial intelligence, AI. Once only something talked about in certain corners of our world or imagined in science fiction, AI is rapidly becoming a part of our life. Much of it is having positive impact on our efficiency and effectiveness. In areas where we have human intelligence, HI, artificial intelligence can help us become better versions of ourselves. However, as with anything new, there is a risk that it gets overused and used in areas where it really doesn't contribute. That's a bad idea. You cannot have AI unless you have HI. AI applications only work in areas where we have developed vast HI. We can use AI to build and mostly fly planes. We can use AI to build and mostly drive cars. The map apps on our phone are able to get us places we want to go far easier than even a few years ago. AI is beginning to move into the helping sector. And we're learning in the TCOM space that AI can already do certain things where HI exists. For example, we can now train a natural language processor to read a case vignette and reliably rate the cans. This is possible because we have a large number of vignettes with carefully developed suggested ratings that we can use to train the machine. In other words, the HI exists to translate a case vignette into a can's rating. The next step of this journey would be to begin to use these techniques to write vignettes that are optimally effective for training. We have enormous human intelligence regarding which vignettes are the most effective for reliability and training. We can use that AI to train the machine. However, can we train the machine to listen to a conversation between an interviewer and a person to allow the completion of the cans? We don't yet have sufficient HI for that to be possible. We need far more information about how people refer to different aspects of the standard language used in an assessment before we can build that type of machine. Even if we're able to capture the words people use, we would not necessarily be able to replicate the relationship between the interviewer and the interviewed. We know some interviewers are better able to rapidly create trusting relationships than others. If we do not build an HI understanding of this type of complexity into the AI, then the AI will be forced into a mechanical solution to the interviewing process. You can see that type of mechanization of interviewing already in bot help desks. That might make sense to helping a customer with a problem. It may not make any sense in talking to someone about sensitive topics like trauma experiences or symptoms. We currently should not use AI to create models to decide referral to residential treatment or even referral to most intervention programs because we simply do not have sufficient information about what works for whom across various circumstances and groups. We need to stay with decision support models based on our best understanding, but allow expert override. AI is here to stay. As with all change, it is pointless to resist and try to live in the past. Better to embrace and harness it for good. As you look at any AI application, ask yourself, what data did the developers use? On what human intelligence is this application built? Does such human intelligence currently even exist? There's an old saying from the early days of the information age, garbage in, garbage out. The same is true for artificial intelligence. In the absence of sufficient human intelligence, you could use AI methods, and it will be artificial, but it won't be particularly intelligent.